Good morning, my dear class 7 students. Welcome back to the online session of maths classes. Today we are going to discuss subtraction of algebraic expressions. Now you are familiar with addition of algebraic expressions. So let us start subtraction of algebraic expressions. First question is, negative 5y square from y square. First, write the algebraic expression for this statement. Now, you can see I have written the algebraic expression for the following. Y square minus negative 5y square. Y square minus negative 5y square. Now, as we have discussed for integers, first term as such, subtraction sign will change to addition sign and additive inverse of the second expression. Here, once again, first expression as such, subtraction sign changes to addition sign and additive inverse of the second expression. Now you can see both are like terms, so apply rule of addition. 1y square plus 5y square. So you will get the answer as positive 6y square. Let's see the second question. What is the question? A minus B from A plus B. A minus B from A plus B. So you should write whatever comes after from first, subtraction sign and the second expression. Let us write the algebraic expression for this. Now you can see I have written the algebraic expression for this. A plus B minus A minus B. First expression as such, subtraction sign will change to addition sign and additive inverse of the second expression. Now you can see I have written the first expression as such, subtraction sign changed to addition sign and additive inverse of the second expression. Now combine the like terms. You can see I have combined the like terms A minus A plus B plus B. Okay. So what is A minus A? 0. Plus 1B plus 1B? 2B. So final answer is 2B. Hope you understood. Now let's go for the third one. 5A square minus 7AB plus 5B square from 3AB minus 2A square minus 2B square. Students, here you are subtracting two trinomials. Okay, children. So first, write the algebraic expression for this. Now you can see I have written whatever comes after from first, then subtraction sign and then the first expression. Now, what to do? First expression as such, subtraction sign changes to addition sign, additive inverse of the second expression. Now, I have written the first expression as such, subtraction sign changed to addition sign, second expression, additive inverse. 5a square became minus 5a square, minus 7ab became plus 7ab, plus 5b square became minus 5b square. Now, combine the like terms, 3ab plus 7ab, minus 2a square, minus 5a square, minus 2b square, minus 5b square, and then apply rule of addition. Now I have applied the rule of addition. 3 plus 7, 10. Here both the numbers are negative, so you will add 2 plus 5, 7, and negative sign. Negative 2, negative 5, negative 7, b square. So what will be the final answer? Final answer will be 10ab minus 7a square minus 7b square. This is the basic concept which you have to do while subtracting two algebraic expressions. Let us see the fourth question. 4pq minus 5q square minus 3p square from 5p square plus 3q square minus pq. Now I have written the algebraic expression for this statement. Now what to do? First expression as such, subtraction sign changes to addition sign, additive inverse of the second expression. Now combine the like terms. 5p square plus 3p square plus 3q square plus 5q square minus pq minus 4pq, and apply the rule of addition. Now you can see I have combined the like terms and applied the rule of addition. 5 plus 3, 8. 3 plus 5, 8. Minus 1, minus 4, minus 5. So what will be the final answer? 8p square plus 8q square minus 5pq. Here the final answer you can see. By this we end today's session of subtraction of algebraic expression. Students, be thorough with the basic subtraction problems, then only you can go for the word problems. Thank you. Have a nice day.